does it mean to burn fat? Where does it even go? Despite what Doctor Who suggests, it doesn't just grow legs and walk away. It actually disappears into thin air. Hey guys, Julie here for DNews. New year brings new resolutions. For many, that means getting back to the gym. Feel the burn seems to be the rallying cry for exercise enthusiasts everywhere. And how many magazines have flashy covers like 10 new ways to burn fat in the new year? And what does that even mean? How can you burn fat and where does it go? When you eat too much protein or carbs, your body converts it and stores it as fat. To get your body to burn up these cells, your body has to use up the immediate energy from food and dip into your energy reserves. In other words, you burn more calories than you take in, so you have to use your fat stores. And that adipose tissue or fat is made up of fat cells called adipocytes, filled with molecules called triglycerides. When you're trying to burn fat, you're really trying to get rid of these triglycerides, high levels of which are linked with heart disease and metabolic syndrome. Triglycerides are made up of glycerol and three fatty acids. In order to burn fat, you have to oxidize these molecules. Now, the complete oxidation of a single triglyceride involves many biochemical processes and enzymes, but the process can be boiled down to a single chemical equation. Now, this may look pretty complicated, but what's basically happening here is that when you're exercising, you're tapping into your fat stores. So you're oxidizing or breaking down that molecule to release carbon dioxide, water, and energy. I bet you're imagining that most of that fat gets turned into energy, like your gym teacher or personal trainer tells you. Well, they'd be wrong. According to a study published in the British Medical Journal, most of the fat turns into carbon dioxide and water. According to their calculations, 84% of an adipose triglyceride is given off as CO2. So for example, if you lose 10 kilograms of fat, 8.4 kilograms is exhaled as CO2. As the lead author says, when someone burns fat, most of the mass is breathed out as carbon dioxide. It goes into thin air. The rest is given off as water in some way or another, like in urine, sweat, tears, or other bodily fluids. The authors also calculated about how much carbon dioxide we give off in an average day. Even without hitting the treadmill, with every breath we take, we give off 33 grams of carbon dioxide. Woohoo! Before you get too excited about losing all that CO2 and burning all that fat, the authors also note that a single muffin contains 20% of your daily intake of energy. A single lousy muffin. So a small amount of food can quickly make all that exercise for naught. But if you do want to get more bang for your breath, you can actually measure how much fat you're burning by measuring your breath. So if you want to stick to that New Year's resolution, take a deep breath, hit the gym, and feel the burn. Losing weight in the future will be weird. Not only will your breath keep track of how much fat you're burning, but an algorithm will decide what you should be eating. To find out more about that, check out this episode right here. Microbiomes are the ecosystems living in all of us. Each of us carry around millions of microbes in our gut. And other studies, like one published in the journal Science, found that gut bacteria could be the crucial factor in a person's metabolism. We know you love watching online, but we're excited to announce DNews is now on the Science Channel. Trace and Amy will be sharing a minute of the best in science in between awesome programming. So check out as Science presents DNews at 9, every weeknight, Monday through Friday, and use your Twitter to let them know if you want more. So how do you guys exercise or keep in shape? Let us know. You can tell us down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons while you're at it, and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.